Do you remember? We have discussed in detail about the metals. Today, we are going to discuss about non-metals. Non-metals can be in two forms: solids, for example, ice. Ice melts from the heat of the sun. It does not have the features of a metal. Another example, chocolate. We all like to eat chocolates. When we eat it, it immediately melts in our mouth. It is also a non-metal. Another form of non-metal can be in gaseous form. Gases do not have the features of a metal. It means they are non-metal. You must remember, in the previous video, we have discussed about metals, its types, and its features in detail. But you must know that non-metals are very few. So we will have a short discussion in this topic. Let's see here. Now we are going to discuss about non-metals. We will discuss the difference between metals and non-metals. I'll tell you the points, then you can do the comparison between the two. First point, metals. Metals are malleable and ductile. It can be changed into various forms and shapes. For example, gold coins, gold biscuits, etc. Non-metals. Non-metals are brittle. They does not have the features of a metal. Second point. Metals are hard, but the hardness is different for different metals. For example, a hammer. It is made up of a hard metal. Plastic is an example of a non-metal. It can break very easily. It does not possess any of the physical properties of metals. Third point. Metals are good conductors of electricity. The power transmission lines carry electric current. The electrical wires are made up of metals. We connect the USB cable of a charger to our phone to recharge the battery. This cable has electric wire inside it, which carry the electricity and help to charge the phone. Without a USB cable, can a phone be charged? No. So non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. What is carbon? Let me tell you. Earlier we have discussed that the metals have metallic luster. They have a shiny surface in their pure state. And non-metals do not have luster like metals, but there are few exceptions. Carbon is a non-metal, but it is lustrous. Now let us discuss what carbon is. Carbon is solid and has a rough texture. Why is it so? Because carbon is made up of atoms. Look at this picture. Did you see that? They are the smallest particle of a chemical element that can exist. Carbon is an element. Carbon atoms are arranged in a regular pattern. This creates the shape and texture of carbon. Let's take another example. In a small particle of sugar, atoms are present. They are very small particles. If we add a small particle of sugar to the water, it will dissolve after some time because the polar water molecules attract the negative and positive ions on the polar sucrose molecules, which makes sucrose dissolve in water, and we get a sweet solution. This is because of the chemical reaction of atoms. Similarly, all the objects around us, like furniture, electrical devices, etc., are composed of atoms. It is invisible. So this was the explanation about non-metals.